Let's illustrate the technique of separating variables by doing an example. So let's solve the equation y prime times y plus x equals 0. You may remember this equation from the very first video. It was one of the examples I gave you. All right, so how are we going to solve this? Well, the first step is to write it in the form that we require to apply the technique of separating variables, and that is in the form dy dx, or y prime, equals a ratio of a function of x and a function of y. And in this case, a little algebra will get us dy dx equals minus x divided by y. Perfect. Okay, now we apply that trick for remembering what to do, and that is we put the dx on the side with the x, and we put the y on the side with the dy. So we multiply through by dx and multiply through by y. That's the trick to remember. So we have y dy equals minus x dx. Now these things were born to be integrated, so let's integrate them. So we have the integral of y with respect to y, integral of y dy, equals the integral of minus x with respect to x, integral of minus x dx. If we carry out those integrals, we get 1 half y squared plus some arbitrary constant equals minus 1 half x squared plus some arbitrary constant, c2. All right, let's do a little simplifying. Let's multiply through both sides by 2, so we get y squared plus 2c1 equals minus x squared plus 2c2. Now c1 and c2 are both completely arbitrary constants that come from the integration, so we can combine the two into one constant c, which is equally as arbitrary. So for example, I could subtract 2c1 from both sides. Now if I move the x squared over to the left-hand side, I get y squared plus x squared equals c. This is the implicit solution that I referred to. I do not have y written explicitly as a function of x, so y is defined implicitly as a function of x by this equation. Now this should look familiar. It's a circle, as long as c is positive. If c is negative, then I don't have any real solutions over here as for y as a function of x. Okay, now I could solve and get an explicit solution, so let's do that. So if I solve for y as a function of x, I subtract x squared from both sides, and I get y squared equals c minus x squared. Now I can take the square root, but there's two square roots I could take. Y equals square root of c minus x squared, that's the top half of the circle, or y equals minus square root of c minus x squared, that's the bottom half of the circle. So these are the explicit solutions. Now I invite you to check both of these versions of the solutions with the original equation and make sure that this guy solves the original equation by applying implicit differentiation, and make sure that both of these guys explicitly solve the equation by simply differentiating and checking that the equation is satisfied.